Hi all, welcome to Trix. As we all know that few days ago in Delhi, public health emergency was declared due to increased level of air pollution. The air pollution in Delhi reached to the category of severe according to the air quality index. I have already made a video on air quality index. You can watch that video, link will be in the description. According to AQI, the 0 to 50 level indicates good level of air, while 51 to 100, whose color is green, indicates moderate level, 101 to 150 indicates unhealthy, while 301 to 500 indicates hazardous level. In Delhi, PM2.5 reached to the level of 389 on 28th October. After Diwali, it reached to 400. There are different sources which contribute to the concentration of PM2.5 in the air. These are dust storms, open fires, passenger vehicles, freight vehicles, on-road dust, power plants, DG sets, industries, household, open waste burning, natural sources, non-India sources and global sources. And among all these, open fires alone contribute to 63.1% in PM2.5. And in Delhi, according to a government source, the contribution is almost 40%. However, we cannot blame only open fires, the stubble burning by the farmers of Punjab and Haryana, but other factors also contribute in the situation of Delhi. We will discuss about that in some time. First of all, let us understand what is smog, how it is different from photochemical smog. Smog is a mixture of two words, smoke plus fog. It is a mixture of various gases with dust and water. A grey color of cloud is formed. The sky of Delhi became grey. A hazy condition is formed. Visibility is reduced. It occurs due to factors like geography, sunlight, industrial activity, vehicular emissions, calmness of winds, burning of coal, etc. It usually occurs at a place which is far away from the actual source of pollution, and that is why stubble burning in the adjoining states impacts the air in Delhi. We can understand it through a simple diagram. First, burning of coal and fuel releases sulfur dioxide and particulates. And then, due to stagnant air, humidity, cloud cover, or due to inversion of temperature, concentrated sulfurous smog is formed. Inversion of temperature is very important term to understand.
Temperature inversion is reversal of temperature. In the normal pattern, as we go up, temperature decreases. At the ground level, there is warm air, then cool, then cooler air. But in the reversal of temperature, as we go up, temperature increases. What happens is that during extended periods of high pressure in winter months, solar radiation reaches the ground, warming it up. At night, there is lack of cloud cover, which means the ground loses heat rapidly and the air in contact with the ground becomes colder. So the warmer air rises and acts as a lid, trapping the colder air close to the ground. And so the pollution, including that from the road traffic, is also trapped. So the air layer closest to the ground becomes more and more polluted. This continues until the prevailing meteorological condition changes.
I will further explain the situation in Delhi using the map. First of all, let us try to understand the photochemical smog. It is a type of air pollution due to the reaction of solar radiation with airborne pollutant mixtures of nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds. These nitrogen oxides and volatile organic compounds are emitted from vehicles due to burning of coal, wood, paint fumes, etc. These are primary pollutants, and when these primary pollutants undergo reactions with other chemicals already present in the atmosphere, they form secondary pollutants. Example are tropospheric ozone, particulates produced from gaseous primary pollutants, and PAN. These three form photochemical smog, and these are secondary pollutants. First of all, nitrogen oxide reacts with volatile organic compounds, giving nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide again reacts in the presence of sunlight, forming nitrogen oxide and giving a free oxygen. This free oxygen then reacts with oxygen, forming ozone. This ground level ozone is very irritating gas, and that is why it is included in the AQI and monitored under it. Then again, nitrogen dioxide reacts with volatile organic compound means the there is cycle going on. First, nitrogen oxides react with VOC forming nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide then again reacts with VOC forming PAN, which is peroxyacetyl nitrate. So the net result is nitrogen oxide plus volatile organic compound plus oxygen in the presence of sunlight giving ozone and PAN and other oxygens, and this is what photochemical smog is forms during summertime. So this is the difference between smog and photochemical smog. Now let us have a detailed look at different factors that contribute in the smog condition in Delhi. Now there is so much hue and cry regarding stubble burning by farmers in Haryana and Punjab. That is not the only reason for the situation in Delhi. The geographical location of Delhi is also very important, because see, these cities such as Chennai and Hyderabad are also equally populated and industrialized. There are so many automobile industries in Hyderabad and Chennai, refineries are also there. But what happens is that air from Bay of Bengal replenishes the air in these cities, so such situations are not formed. But in Delhi, the air from the coast picks the dust particle from the Thar Desert. Thar Desert has Delhi in its northeast side. Then northwesterly winds that blow from here picks up pollutants from along the number of refineries in its way. Next, the air that blows from here gets trapped just below the Himalayan mountains and not able to escape very quickly. Again, here in the southern side of Delhi, there is central plain. So there is a kind of stagnancy in the air, and Delhi acts like a bowl where the air seeps in and not able to escape very quickly, aggravating the condition of smog. So geography is also a prime factor in Delhi's situation. Apart from that, natural phenomena such as the cyclonic condition in Maharashtra and Gujarat in the Arabian Sea cause the stagnancy in air, and we know that calmness and wind also extends the condition of smog. It doesn't let the air to blow away. So natural phenomena is also a contributing factor. So we can see that geography, natural phenomena, global sources such as the pollutants that are picked by the northwesterly winds, then man-made activities such as vehicular emissions, industrial emissions and crop burning. These all contribute in the smog condition in Delhi. So I hope I was able to explain everything in simple terms. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Press that bell icon to receive the notification for my next video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.